Hey, it's the After Eight Mint Show with the Earworms and me doing some turning in the background. Champion man. Good evening, good evening, good evening. And just bring the guy straight in. We've got JP. We've got Sugar Day Night Fever. And we've got Andrew the Rockstar, AGK.
Hi, guys.
There we go.
He hasn't got anything YouTube to blow, channel. Just his own trumpet, anyway. Just his own trumpet. I got number one holler.
Anyway.
I'm right, starting now. He's back in the background again. Right, let's change camera. See what I'm doing.
Camera.
Change camera. That's it. Right, so on the lathe tonight, we have got a small piece of ash. Yes, I'm doing ash again.
Ooh.
It's but about 15 like and a half inches.
Would you like to rephrase that, please, Wayne?
No. No. I'm sure she'll understand.
How about no?
So it's about 15 and a half inches diameter. It'll end up around about 15. It'll end up around about 2 inches deep. So it's going to have a fairly plain bottom. I was waiting for somebody saying something.
Yeah. Yeah.
I was shocked to say it.
I was sitting here thinking, someone's got something better than me on this one.
Yeah. But on the top, I'm maybe going to use the Dremel in the jig again to see if we can do something a bit different. So let's get started. So I'm turning at around about 750. And let's get some turning done.
Oh, yeah.
Go ahead, Chuck.
Yes, without further ado, let's have a look at who's here. Well, obviously, AGK's not here, according to the participants. Oh, well, what can I say? He's normally top of the list. No, mate, no. It says in participants.
Oh, I know where he is. I know where he is, Chuck.
Yeah. The first person on my participants list is. Are you ready, JP?
Yeah.
I need a number one hollower. Then we have Barry Shitty, Billy Brown, Barney and the Jets. Is he gonna? Is he? No. Yes. There we go. We've got Colin Izzard and Door 60, Fred Gilliver, James Crawford, Knights Eternal, Mark Pritchard, Paul Hooten, the Greasby Turner, Susie, the Swisswood Turner, Rain, Sleet or Snow, Ditchfinder General, the Mailman, Martin Breeze. We've got
Emotional Damage.
We've got Scott the Blue Light Turner himself. We've got Uwe Klein. We've got, are you ready, JP?
Yeah.
Ward Wilson.
This is whole other country.
Yes! The man himself, the wood maestro, Mr. Wayne the Wood Turnerer.
That's me, that is.
That's him, that is. And we've got Chase Woodworks. Now, that's the only ones that are coming up on my participants list. So if I see you in the chat, we'll call you out. Ash at Coyte Shed has joined us as well.
How you doing?
Martin said he's listening whilst building a wedding arch. Nice.
Very nice. He knows what to do with a wedding arch after he's built it. Right in the ditch.
Now, if anybody missed Saturday morning cartoons today, go back and have a watch. Jamie was doing a bit of a stand-in because Jake's sorting family stuff out. and he did this amazing bowl. And the top is done with UV resin.
Nice. Oh, he's just joined us. Security himself. The Homie Depot. Joey! You've got a friend in me. Oh, and Pancho.
And Pancho. Pancho.
Oh, yeah. Can't forget Pancho.
Star of the show, really, Pancho.
Yeah.
Pancho does need his own Instagram.
Yeah.
He does. Pancho, we've got to start a petition now. We've got to start a petition that Pancho gets his own Instagram.
You definitely. Mick Jews has joined us. Are you ready, JP? So has Mark L.
Yeah, I got it. Can you hear me?
Yes.
And Malcolm Douglas. Hello, mate.
Everybody's got to message Joey on his Instagram and say, is this how I get through to Pancho?
Can I speak to Pancho Villa, please? Jennifer's Craft and Creations has joined us. I think it may be the real one. We'll wait and see.
Jennifer?
We'll only know if Mark comes Jennifer. In. Mark the impersonator.
That's a no. Joey says that's no.
It'll be a yes soon, Joey. Believe you and me.
Joey said no.
Oh, Jacob from Jacked Up Leatherworks joined us. Hello, mate.
Hey, Jacob.
How you doing?
Just use my big skew chisel to form the mortise here.
Excuse me.
Oh, yeah.
Martin said, this wedding arch is shaped like a coffin. Coincidence? I think not. Oh, dear. Oh, we're starting early. We're starting early.
I can't wait to see that. I can't wait to see that quiver.
Me neither.
I can't wait to see it either.
Me neither. I think it'll be very cool. And I bet you got JP going, I want one of them.
I do want one of them. I take it on demos with me.
Actually, I want five of them, one for each of my number one holders. Oh, I smell a rat here. Jennifer said Mark won't be coming in the chat tonight as the battery on his phone has gone. Ah, maybe that is
Why
Mark.
Why did you steal it?
No. Maybe that really is Mark. I mean, it wouldn't be the first time he's impersonated. Good advice, Anita. She said, pace yourself. Ward is asking, does anybody know what time Steve is coming on tomorrow with the hashtag fruit montage?
Would that be
it'll be 1 o'clock.
Yeah, he normally does one on a Sunday, doesn't he? Alan Roper's joined us, and he said, just logged on. What are we making today, Wayne? Not another ash bowl. Yes, he's doing ash again today.
Yeah, I'm doing ash again.
Douglas Mungham's joined us. Hello, mate.
You got to be careful, Wayne. You end up boring people. That's what we found out. We've got to change things up.
You've got to speed it up. And then you've got to
change it down. Up. You got to do something and not get out your ass. Boom.
And you will find that babing is fine.
When you're going to leave me.
Jen's joined us. Jen.
Hey, Jen.
Hiya, Jen.
Did a fantastic job of helping me out today.
Yeah,
you did.
Did Andrew kick anybody out?
No.
Nah.
Yeah, it's only because it's only because I wasn't able to come in. That's what it was. He blocked me.
Yeah.
Oh dear.
I'm sure at some point you'll get the opportunity.
What are you doing next Saturday, Shug?
What am I doing next Saturday? Probably a bit more of the same. I'm kind of a bit in it at the minute.
Oh dear.
Yeah, it'll be alright. We'll get there. Playing a bit of catch up, so.
We need to get you to go live show so we can start a number one hollower fund.
Kevin9K Creations has joined us, and so has John McDonald. Good afternoon, you guys.
Hi, Kev. Hi, John.
I don't think people will see it quite as relevant when I go live, Jamie. Not a buy me a coffee, a buy me a number one hollower fund.
Yeah.
And there's me and the lads, just, you know.
The trouble you got is, though, Shug, is people turn up to see the number one hollower, not to not see it.
Oof.
That's true.
Oof. Hold on a minute, let me just check. Oh, no, I'm wearing my box. My love spuds are okay. Mark's in. Hello, Mark.
Hello, Mark. I saw your post earlier. Well done, mate.
Yeah, well done, Mark.
What did I miss?
Hit the search bar and find out.
Yeah.
Not while I'm in the middle of the live.
Mark is now an accredited tutor with the AWGB.
Oh, there you go. Well done, mate. Well done.
There you go. Means you can take a cane to school with him.
Have you got your football boots, boy?
Yeah, there you go. What was that guy's name? He played a military guy.
Windsor Davis,
that's it. I can imagine Mark walking around doing that. You'll pick up that gouge, boy.
Ride the bevel. Lovely boys.
Robin, that's Yorkshire grit. Sand 240.
Gets you to that sanding, boy.
You forgot the conversation starter.
I'm not reading that out.
Mark says, thanks, guys. Are you ready, Wayne? And a special thanks to Wayne for starting me off on this journey and all of his continued support and guidance.
Cheers, mate.
He didn't say anything about Jamie, though, and his number one hollower, did he?
No, no. See, if it weren't for Wayne talking about all this Oak Island stuff, he wouldn't have known anything about wood.
Well, yeah, there is that. Mark started the group as a welder. Mark Pritchard's got a scoot, so he'll catch us later. No worries, Mark. You have a good one, mate.
Take it easy.
See you later, Mark.
Are you waiting for the sequel, Mark? Have you heard about it? It's called Ash Island.
Ash Island.
Yeah, it's underneath Wayne's lathe.
It's a real treasure under there, like a Proxon long neck grinder.
Yeah, you're right there.
And the other thing, like Oak Island, you'll never get to the bottom of it.
Probably about right, mate. Good call. There we go, look.
He's going to put a sunroof into his workshop later. Stick his head out the top of it.
So the texturing tool's around about 2 o'clock then, Wayne, the angle.
Yeah.
Right.
It is. You can have it
at different rate. I've still got the bar on this for setting the angle for when I was doing the spiraled stem. If I'm usually on balls, I don't have this on, but I can't be bothered taking it to bits.
Yeah.
But you can use it. You can get different patterns depending on what angle you've got it at.
Yeah.
But I'm going to be doing some texturing stuff on Wednesday because Anita asked the other day.
Yeah, that's cool.
I need a texture in.
Okay.
Apparently JP needs texturing. Hmm. Go and get plastered, JP. That works.
Yeah, there you go.
Beat back up again.
Drilly! Chase said, sounds like the maple shavings in my backyard. Oh, nice wood maple.
I think I've got a little bit of maple left.
I haven't. I did have a little bit, but only pen blanks, which was a shame. But we used to use it for the office furniture handles and stuff. It was nice for that.
Mm. I've got maybe one or two fairly big blanks left, I think. Shut up, Alexa.
Please.
Alexa was trolling you, Wayne. She was trolling you, Wayne. Oh,
where's your manners page? Shut up, Alexa, please. Oh, no. It started already. Kev at 9K Creations asked, Wayne, why didn't you cut the paper round? Okay.
No, you know what? It's Joey that normally asks that.
The truth of the matter is, right, I buy rolls of paper like this, and I can't see the point in cutting it round, so all I do is get a pair of sky saws.
Yeah, sky saws.
And just cut a square off. It works just as well.
Donna's joined us. Hello, Donna.
Evening, Donna.
Chase says, Shug, you pay shipping and I'll send you all the maple blanks you want.
I'm happy with that. If Shug pays shipping, he can send me a blank.
If I pay shipping, I could probably buy a forest of maple over here from what I'm seeing lately.
And a number one hollower.
Oh.
And then a quiver for your number one hollower.
Oh, good job. I've got a box on, lads. Yeah. Good job. I've got a box on.
And probably a few extra cutters for your number one hollower as well.
Oh.
Along with some negative rate cutters for your number one hollower as well.
Joey says...
But when are you doing resin?
Joey says, and I quote, I only ask you, JPP pants.
Yeah. You added that little bit.
I did, yeah. after posting pics of my turnings, people actually want to buy my work. What the hell have I started? I blame Wayne, said Alan Roper. Nice, Alan.
Well, if you don't want to sell them, Alan, send them in my direction.
And Wayne will sell them. Mick Jews is saying, Mark, a question for you. Will you be teaching the number one hollower?
If he wins it on my giveaway, he will.
He may be teaching people how to lock them up so I can't get hold of them. Chase is asking a question. Is that some conversation starter? It is.
That was a conversation starter, Chase.
It is. Laurie's in.
See what happened?
Hello, Laurie.
Hello, Laurie.
I sprayed that on and Chase started a conversation. That's how it works.
Yeah. Hiya, Laurie. Laurie, so be right.
Hey, mm-hmm. Laurie.
Douglas Mangum says, question. Olive's ash. Yeah. He upset Popeye using it.
Yeah. Olive ash.
Nice. Do it for Yorkshire.
Do it for Yorkshire.
For
how? Do it for Yorkshire.
Oh, I sang that while it was on. So sorry, guys, you missed it.
Yeah, don't do it again.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, because it's your turn next time.
Mark L says, speaking of which, Ashley seems to be absent. I know, it's nice and quiet, isn't it?
Yeah. Saturday tends to be Ashley's family time. She does a lot of family stuff on a Saturday and a Sunday, I've got to say, as well.
And Monday through Friday as well. Ashley's very much a family person.
Exactly. Anita's saying, Anita, be a winner. I think you've won your lot.
Anita needs to be disqualified.
Hey! That's below the belt, Anita. Feel free to launch a kick in his direction.
She turned around and has come out one day and says, I hate the pickle wheel. It never picks me. And then picked her 2 weeks in a row.
Yeah. Yeah. Alan Roper said, listen to Sean Bean and say it properly. Mm-hmm. Because winter is coming. and I'm not being funny, but I'm not even going to quote the word that Sean Bean has said the most on the television so far. It's well documented on YouTube, guys. In the search bar. There you go. Douglas sung it for you. If you listen very carefully on the replay, you might hear it.
You can just hear it.
Jamie must be checking it about now.
What's that?
Jacob's asking, Jamie, how close are you to the 10K subscribers?
Let's have a look. I am on 9,863 at the moment. So not that far.
William Rose has joined us as well. Hello, buddy.
Evening, William.
Hello.
Mark L, silent music, every bit as good as silent movies. And twice as useful. Because you can see.
Here's a question from the chat. Here's a question from the chat. And we got this idea from Jen. So we all know how much Shug wants a number one hollower.
Oh, God.
But If there was one tool that you could, all could have, what would it be? That includes you, Shug.
Oh, no, I couldn't possibly, because it's not actually a number one hollower. If it was money, no option. There you go. Ward said a proper jointer. Plasma. I've got one. I've got plasma.
I've got a proper jointer.
I'd like a proper CNC laser table, but the space you'd need for it, the money you'd need for it, and the brains you need for it, I don't have any of. So, oh, I want to make stuff, Sin. Hello, mate.
How you doing?
Anita Ball said, a muzzle for Jamie. Yeah! Shots fired, as Jamie would say.
Have a word with Jacked Up. I didn't think he was into that kind of stuff, Anita, if I'm honest.
Wow. Right, let's have a look. David, a.k.a. that guy that Wood Turns, is in. Hello, mate.
How you doing?
Also joining us is
Shane.
Hello, mate.
Hey, Shane.
Douglas is asking, if he hits the sub on your site 1,000 times, will that get you there?
If he has 1,000 different YouTube channels.
Mark L said, going to stick with a laser engraver cutter. Chase has got to hit the tool he wants, but he needs to get it there. And the picture, the short video he sent me of this thing going up the stairs is quite hilarious. Donna wants a new workshop. Oh, Kevit9K Creations wants a nice sized bandsaw. Oh, I've just got rid of one.
Oh, yeah.
I've got one of them as well.
Who was it that was offering a supplier for one? He was going to get me some Cute Elite.
Yeah, yeah. He didn't get me one either, did he?
He actually had my Cute Elite.
Laser peckers are brill, said Kev.
Yeah, I think Scott's got one of them, I think.
He has, yeah.
That's Blowy making noise.
Blowy! Windy, how can you...
Nearly fucking shit myself then.
Oh, that's what it was then. Weren't the competitor at all.
Wayne's got wind.
Joey concurs with Anita 100%. Fred Gilliver said magic hands to replace the duff one. John Scarborough's joined us. Hello, John.
Hey, John.
William Rose says a time machine. Oh, that's just cheating. But it would be good.
Yeah, you could jump in time when you got your number one hollower.
Yeah, good, yeah. And then jump back and have it early. Glyn's in!
Hello, Glyn.
Hey, Glyn.
You're just in time, Glyn. We'll be.
He's not. He's too late.
No. We'll be using Yorkshire Grit soon, and Andrew's going to sing it. Bus cut thunder. No, we've just used it on the other side, Glyn. Lovely. Yes, David, lucky we can't smell.
Smell-o-vision.
Chuckle-chuckle-vision to me, to you, to you, to me.
Vision. Sugar vision.
Sugar, sugar vision.
That's nearly got it.
Yeah, I think he's right. Mark said, Kev, my only concern is that they can engrave but aren't able to cut, as I understand it. I presume he means the laser pecker. But I'm sure you can deal with that on the 3018, though.
Okay, right. Something's just been brought to our attention. Glyn said he used to live in the same village as the Chuckle Brothers. So from this day forth, Glyn should now be known as the Chuckle Cousin.
Chuckle, chuckle, cousin. Chuckle, chuckle, cousin.
Chuckle, cousin. Chuckle, cousin.
To Glyn, to me, to Glyn.
To you.
To me, to you, to Glyn.
Ah, so it was Crowell near Scunthorpe. I did not know that. Chuckle, cousin. Actually, could that's a scary thought, actually. Glyn and the Chuckle Brothers all in the workshop at Yorkshire Grit HQ. To me, to just moving stuff about. To me, to you, to you. No, just put it down.
The boxes never got opened. They can carry on passing them to each other.
Put it down and step away, please. Ward Wilson said, back to the search bar. I think he's looking up the Chuckle Brothers. To me, to you, Ward. To me. Neither of them with the sharpest chisel in the box. Unlike my parting tool. Oh, that was sharp.
That to me, to you. To me, to you. That I'm sure that was Mark and Stephen with the diamond belt.
Yeah, I had nothing to do with it.
Scott said, it's not the diamond belt Glyn's looking for, it's the chuckle belt. Oh. Oh.
Doris Hacker creation. He's found a way to hack her.
Alan Roper's doing a John McEnroe impression. You cannot be serious. Evening, Doris.
Hiya, Doris. Hello, Doris.
You've been the chip shop tonight, Doris.
Doris.
Yes, I'm not sure if it's a real Doris. Maybe someone should run a background check.
It says it's a real Doris.
Oh, hello. Glyn's got a bit of news, he said. Newsflash. Steinert are the new German distributor for Yorkshire Grit.
Nice. Excellent.
Nice. Well done.
Horse sprung dirt technique.
You will have some.
How much is Yorkshire Grit in Germany? We ask the questions.
Oh, God. James Twink. It is, isn't it?
That looked really nice. It's a Yorkshire Grit on it.
Here you go, Wayne. Glyn said, I can feel some barter coming on as they are now the manufacturer of the VB36.
Yeah, they have been for years.
Yeah.
But yes, Glyn, seeing as how you're supplying them, they should be supplying you with stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Just don't go for the blue and yellow lid, though.
Or black and yellow.
Mark's thinking about changing his logo.
I think Doris has noticed. Oi, what do you think you are doing? What's going on?
Yeah, but they're both Doris and Crafted Creations now. I don't know who's the real one. I'm going to ban them both.
You just figured it out, Buster. Better change it back.
You're going to catch a little nubbin on the end?
No, that's all last year, that is.
All right.
Right, let's see if I can bugger this up totally.
That is nice.
And now, from Dumfries, it's the Wizard of the Week. Glyn is saying, I've got Shug and Jamie. Who's the other earworm? It's Andrew from AGK, mate. Hi, over Glenn. To you, Andrew.
He's just about to start putting videos out, mate. He ain't got one out there yet.
Are you going up to Harrogate, Andrew?
I am.
Right. Glyn, you'll get to meet them up at Harrogate.
Yeah.
He lives near you. Don't you live near Glyn's neck of the wood? Not far away.
It's not far away, no. No.
Yeah, I'm Ghoul. Who lives in Ghoul? Right. Here we go.
Oh, Ghoul in the East Riding of Yorkshire?
Absolutely.
Yeah. Nice to work up there.
Here goes nothing. Right, I've unplugged the lathe. Yes, I've unplugged the lathe.
Oh, nice one, Jacob. He said he might do a 500 subscriber giveaway for a number one hollower quiver.
There you go.
How many times are you going to be entering that then, Jamie?
Loads. I've got loads of channels.
Oh, hold on. Hold on. I'm not sure if I'm smelling something here, Jamie. Anita said, Anita said Andrew is shy like me. Anita, you're not shy. You forget we were there at the Patreon.
Yeah.
I've got curly hair ever since then. Wayne, how big was that piece of ash when you put it on?
It was 15.5 inches diameter.
There you go, William. A big old
one. It'll end up. It's ended up at 15.
Nice.
Yeah, Mark, she is.
On it like a bonnet, Mark. On it like a bonnet.
Right, and now we're going to come through here and see if I can do something on this raised bit here.
And now for something completely different.
Oh, yeah.
Will it work? Won't it work?
No, we'll find out.
That's it, Anita. Might as well be you.
Yeah, Anita, you're not going to win.
Jamie's putting in 3,000 entries for us.
Well done, Jennifer. You keep him in check.
It's going a little bit too... Oh, no, I'll just carry on, buggers.
A little bit tiny, tiny.
Don't listen to him, Anita. You go for it. And if you win it, then go for the number one hollower in Jamie's giveaway as well.
The problem is, if Anita does win my giveaway, I can't do nothing about it because it's random.
Exactly. Yeah. Jay said, that's it, Wayne. Drive it like you stole it.
Bloody index and things just come out.
Uh-oh.
We did say he wanted to mess it up.
No, he said something slightly different. That's different.
Smoking.
Somebody stuff him.
Right, what I'm going to do is back that off a bit.
Yeah, that's better.
That'll do it.
Darryl do.
That'll do it, yeah.
That's right, Mark. Don't let the smoke out of the wood. I let the smoke out of one of my drills once. Oh, absolute devil. Couldn't get it back in there. Never worked the same since. Anita said, I need a tissue. Jamie is making me cry. Yeah, Jamie, you big bully. Big bully, Jamie.
Stop it, Jamie.
Don't worry, Anita.
Well, I'm enjoying it.
Don't worry, Anita. I'll see that Jake gets to find out about it.
He told me to say it.
Yeah, you'll be the best wingman next week when he clips your wings. I'm telling you.
Yeah. Saturday morning cartoons with Jake and Anita.
We'll all be going, Anita, keep it classy. Wayne's got a vicious streak tonight, look.
Right, I'm sick of that.
bored now, said Wayne.
Yeah, bored now. That didn't work.
Well, Mark, how many things has Jamie won in Saturday morning cartoons giveaways?
Zero.
Anita suddenly like, no, I'm out. Just like the Dragon's Den, she's going, no, I'm out. For that reason, I'm out.
fun little fact, though, right, about the giveaways. Right, so when Jake started doing Instagram giveaways, with his pen blanks, I jokingly went ahead and entered, and Jake did it randomly, and the random picker picked out my name as the very 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 first ever giveaway, and Jake was like, "You ain't winning." So
and
it, yeah,
and here's another fun fact for you. Jamie told me about the giveaways, and he said, "Oh yeah, yeah." I said, oh, I'll get in on it. So I did. I applied. I put down for
get out of the way on the Instagram. And the night that they drew it was the night that I was live, drunk as a skunk, with the lads from the fabrication group, and found out from Ruth Amos that I'd won a Lincoln welding helmet worth a couple of hundred quid, which knocked me sideways. And then it comes off that, and I'm all like, whoa, I've just found out. And it comes into a hangout, at which point Jake and Jamie just fell about going, yeah, and you've just won some pen blanks as well. I was like, whoa, what's the third one? I'm still waiting. Good luck comes in threes. Not for me. It's coming twos and oh, oh, man, what a weekend.
Well, actually, it did come in three because you won that scroll saw T-shirt.
Oh, that was before that, though. But yeah, 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 I've won a scroll saw T-shirt as well. Yeah.
There you go.
It's a scroller thing, though, Jake. Andrew, you wouldn't understand.
Okay.
That's what it says on it.
The scroller thing you wouldn't understand.
I think that's why you sent it to me, because it was a scroller thing that I didn't understand. My scroll saw was driving me balmy. Wasn't it, JP?
I should get T-shirts, mate. It's the number one hollower thing you wouldn't understand.
No, that's another one, yeah.
Oh, no.
Or a T-shirt saying number one hollower fan club or I'm in the club.
Yeah.
Oh, no. You're just evil. You'd exclude a man because...
just to let people know, I'm actually working with EasyWood at the moment to create said group.
Oh, you see what I'm saying here?
Yeah,
they're getting all the pictures made to make the group, and we're going to get it going.
Mm-hmm.
So it's actually for anybody that uses EasyWood tools, but it's solely based. It's going to be based around the number one hollower.
Kev at 9K. No, go on, carry on, mate.
I was going to say, but you need to keep it classy. That's what I was going to say.
Well, there won't be no point in me keeping it classy because I won't be allowed to post in there because I ain't got one. Not part of the club. Kev at 9K Creation said, my best was winning some 30-year-old whiskey. Now, to put that into perspective, somebody bought a friend of mine some 30-year-old whiskey. That was £400 for a bottle. So he won some 30-year-old whiskey, which is a few hundred quid. Left it for another 15 years, and then his missus gave it to a white elephant stall. Oh, no! Oh, nice. How about no? He said she hasn't lived it down. I bet it went on to the Tombola and was won for, like, you know, a pound ticket or something. Oh, you'd be mortified, wouldn't you?
I would.
John?
It all depends on if the whiskey is sort of an E or not.
John, Wayne's going to do an in-depth on spiral texturing, etc. on Wednesday. So if you want to look in on Wednesday, mate, There's a good one coming up. Billy Brown said, Kev, it might have lasted 30 days with me. If you won it, though, you wouldn't mind so much. Yeah.
There we go.
JPN Company said, my son, when he was 16 and his friends drank my 1952 bottle of Jim Beam. I was so...
I'm not surprised.
They were too.
Yeah, they would have been, yeah. Oh, my God.
I think around about that time, he'd have been going, "You're not from my loins, boy."
It's from when I was smoking a bandit. When I get home, when I punch your mama in the mouth.
Just going to clean the grain out with some meths.
Yeah, John, there's been teenage a few people. There's been a few people asking about the texture in, so Wayne's going to do one for us on Wednesday. I'm also interested in that, definitely.
Have you got one?
What, texturing tool?
Yeah.
Not yet, but I've had a close look at a few. I had a look when I was in, the other day, Turner's Retreat, and I thought, I like the look of these. Billy Brown's friend was given a bottle of whiskey worth £900, and it was smooth.
I'll bet.
I wouldn't have known. I wouldn't have drank it. I would have been too frightened to drink it because it would vanish.
Yeah, but you would have to have a sip. You would have to have a sip.
No, that's the problem, Andrew. Once it's open, that it gets out the bottle like smoke getting out of a drill. Never open the bottle if you want to keep it, because you won't, and especially if you like it. No. That's it, Kev's right. Once open, it evaporates. True that. True enough.
That's what I kept telling everybody when I was drinking it.
Yorkshire!
Your eyes are so pretty, can be soft as your face, with light brown Yorkshire gritty.
Now, if you hadn't bought any before, you need to now. Because if you buy it, we can stop this. We can make this pain go away.
Yeah.
With every purchase...
For a tub a month, you can make that nightmare disappear.
Yeah. For every tub that's bought, eventually we can chip away and erase this from the internet forever.
Right, I've got that at about 250 now.
Good call, Mark.
Just using the same piece of paper that I applied it with.
10 tubs, Mark.
Well, I bought 2 yesterday.
And pictures already didn't happen.
The question is, though,
Andrew, did you or did you not
do it for Yorkshire?
Mm-hmm.
I
did it for Yorkshire!
Mm-hmm. He did. Donna's got a bottle of Glenmorangie. She's not opened it. She's saving it for a good reason. She doesn't drink very often.
Yeah. I've got a good reason. I've got 10,000 subscribers coming up, Donna.
Mm-hmm. We could drink 1 year
anniversary of Saturday morning cartoons.
We could drink it for SMC.
Yeah, there you go.
Just £2 a month could keep Wayne in alcohol for almost an hour.
£2 a month wouldn't last 5 seconds.
That's a glass. For half a glass.
We need to do one of them commercials, Jamie. Just £2 a month.
Yeah, I know, right? We'll keep a sober Wayne from beating somebody up.
Not too shabby. Not too shabby.
It's lovely bit of dark grain through the middle of that.
We could change it to, for £7 a month, for me and sober Wayne won't have to travel down to his local supermarket because he can afford Amazon Prime.
He can have it delivered via helicopter.
Never get here.
Oh, no, there could
if
be
Jim
a,
was flying, it'd never get here.
Oh, no, there could be a... I think he's arriving soon.
Nice.
That's the bottom.
Very nice.
Oh, with a bit of texture on there. We that's do the like side that with a wee bit of decoration on the side. And that's the inside with the... Can you see the texture?
Yes. Yeah,
I think you can. In that
you
light.
Sure can, mate, yeah.
You can get the texture nice. In that light.
There you go.
So... I thought the Dremel might be strong enough to do those flutes, but obviously it isn't. So I might have to make a new jig for my small palm router to see if that works any better, because I can't afford to buy a Paul Howard fluting jig.
Fluten? That sounded almost German. That sounded almost German then. Flutengruten.
Fluten. Yeah. So, fluten, like Book.
Book. There's Luke. A book. Have a look at the book. It's for a kook. That was them two on that kids program, weren't they?
There we go. Hope you enjoyed that, guys.
Awesome, mate. Awesome. I'm not.
So yeah,
that
Wednesday case. I'll take off the rest on the In fact, I might leave it on to start off with to show how to do a spiral with it. And I'll do some other things with the texturing tool. Bloody sweating.
It's warm up there, mate.
It is warm.
That's better.
It's a nice night.
Right, what's happening in the chat?
Lots of good comments, mate. That's what's happening in the chat.
Could I make a jig for the Proxon? I probably could, Douglas, but I tend to use the Proxon more freehand, so I can get lots of texturing down the side of a vase type of thing. But I probably could. But I'm going to try and make a jig for the... I've got a small palm router that I'm going to try and make a jig for. I probably could have gotten a better cut if I'd used a different bit rather than a Dremel bit, but I want to use a Dremel bit tonight. Posting it as using the Dremel.
Anita said, see you later, guys. You too, Jamie.
See you, Anita.
Bye, Anita.
Bye.
Bye, Anita.
Anita, goodbye.
Nice one, mate.
Right,
nice.
So tomorrow I believe we'll probably have Stephen on at 1 o'clock, although I haven't seen a thing for him yet. I've got a premiere out tomorrow night at 10:30 PM. Jamie will have a premiere out tomorrow night at 11 PM. Both UK time those are, so pop along and have a watch. It'll either be, in fact, I think it'll probably be Pete who's doing Monday lunchtime, because I think Brian's still having problems with his internet, and Terry still isn't fit enough to be on the lathe for a live. So I don't know what's happening tomorrow night. Like I say, I think Brian's still having problems with his internet.
I'll be back on
Wednesday.
Is that the excuse Terry's using?
Yeah.
That he won't be fit enough. Does that mean he's on holiday again or something? Is that the cover version for it? Oh, I'm not fit enough. There he is lying on.
Yeah, he's had a. no, he's. I think. I,
I'm not very sure, but I think he's had a hip replacement. I think.
All right. So he's not in the Balearics then, just in. I'm just, you know, I'm just putting that out there, just floating out there. Because he's been out there the rest
of it. It was close to his Balearics, though.
He shaved his Balearics.
Right then, guys. Thanks everybody for coming in, and thanks to my worms for keeping us up to date with the chat. Although, to tell you the truth, I didn't hear a lot of the chat tonight because the download on my internet is absolutely atrocious tonight. Luckily, the upload was okay. Mm-hmm. And I'm going to hit the button and go and have a drink.
Mm-hmm. Oh, so Bernie.
I'll see if I can do the Harry's in while I hit the